Hi friends, in our previous video we have seen what is Docker Hub, what is public repository, what is private repository, how can we push our images, either customized image or any of the image, to the Docker Hub, and how can we pull the images. All that we have seen now in our earlier video. So in this video we will see what is Docker volume. So before moving to Docker volume, I will say you what is the need of Docker volume. See, suppose I am taking this scenario of a container. Suppose this is a container, okay. So inside the container I will be having multiples of the applications. Multiple applications will be running. Suppose Tomcat is running, Java is running, many applications are running in this container, inside this container, okay. So make sure any of the application which would be running inside the container, they must be having some logs file inside them. They must be having some logs file of all the applications. Then you say, where will the logs file will stay, either in the container or in the host machine. This is the Docker container, okay. So say, where will the host file stay, where will the logs file will go, either in the Docker container or in the host machine. This is the host on top of which Docker container is residing. So obviously all the logs file of this container will reside inside this container. Now suppose take a scenario that your container goes down due to some issue your container died or has been killed or whatever happened, your container goes down. So what will happen in that scenario? Whatever application was there inside that container or whatever logs was there, everything will go, nothing will be residing. So this is a drawback, this is a drawback of the container. So how can we avoid the such situation? Such situation should be avoided then by using the Docker volume. That's why Docker volume came into this scenario. What Docker volume says, that suppose this is my host machine, this is my local host machine on top of which Docker engine is there, and on top of Docker engine container is running, okay. So what I can do with this container, that using the log Docker volume, I can make a soft link of this log to any of the directory in my container, in my host machine. Suppose this is any of the directory. In this directory I can make a soft link. Suppose inside the root directory I am making a soft link of the logs. So whatever the logs will be generated over here inside the container, it will be reflected in this root directory as well. Means this both will become the mirror of each other. Whatever will be modified inside the root will be reflected inside the log, and whatever will be modified inside the logs will be reflected inside the root. So this both will become the mirror of each other. So what is the advantage of Docker volume is that suppose tomorrow or any days your Docker container goes down, so in every of your logs file will be deleted from the container, will be removed. But what the benefit is there, that all the mirror of the logs will be present in the root, inside the root folder, so that you can take the backup, you can take the backup of your logs. So in this scenario Docker volume helps us in a very beautiful way. So now we will see in the practical way that how can we create the Docker volume, okay. And one more thing I want to say, whenever we create the Docker volume, by default var lib docker, this is the root directory of the Docker which I said earlier. So inside this one folder is present, name is volume. So whenever we will create a container, whenever we will create a Docker volume with the create volume command, so the Docker volume will be created by default inside this folder. But we have the flexibility to decide the folder as per our wish. But for that we have to use different command. Both the command we will see in this scenario. So see, here I have written some points for the Docker volume, that Docker volume doesn't persist when the data doesn't persist when that container is no longer, which already I said. Suppose your container goes down and data will not be there. Then in that case, how can we retrieve that data? We are using Docker volume. So it will be difficult to get the data out of the container if another process needs it. So I have mentioned all the points where the Docker volume helps us, so you can get it very easily. So to avoid such scenario, to avoid such situation, we use Docker volume or bind mounts. These two options we do have. So see, with this image you can understand very easily. This is my Docker container. Inside the Docker container, suppose not only the logs file, I can make a soft link of any of the folder, any of the directory, anything which is inside the container. I can make it as a Docker volume to any of the directory in my host machine. So that in here what it is showing, that inside the Docker container, suppose this is the data of the logs file. So I am redirecting, or I am making a soft link of this to my local host machine. Okay. This is my Docker host server. So inside this I am making a Docker volume. So there is a two way to make Docker volume. First command is Docker volume create. If we will use this Docker volume create command, then by default the Docker volume will be created inside this folder. Let us go inside this folder. /doc/var/lib/docker. If I will come inside this, there is will be one folder name is volumes. So you will be having, you will be looking this inside. I came inside this. Actually, I did some practical, so DevOps G, it is showing over here. Let me remove. Yeah. Actually, this is the Linux command, so I'm not going to explain it over here. So yeah, see, now that nothing is present over here. So if I will give ll, nothing is present. So what I will do now, I will run this Docker volume command. Okay, so Docker create volume, any name give any name like my app. Sorry, Docker volume create, not Docker create volume, Docker volume create. So see what will happen. Now my app folder has been created inside this one. Suppose I will create one more, DevOps G. So if you will see, again if you will see, then it should be there. Yeah, then if we will create any other Docker volume create, suppose test, then you will be able to see the test has been created inside this. So what I mean to say, that if whatever the volume you will create, it will come inside this. Okay, by default it is coming inside the var lib Docker volume directory. So but suppose I don't want my volume to be created inside this folder. And how can I avoid from this? See, what I said here in this scenario, that what is the use of Docker volume? We usually make a soft link of any of our containers directory or containers files to our host machine. So what I will do, suppose I will make a directory in my host machine with any name. So what I will do to that directory, I will make a soft link to the container. So let me run the command. I think my server is running slow. Yeah, so what I will do here, I will create a folder name as any name. So mkdir volume test. So I have created one folder with the name of volume test. Okay, now let me see my available Docker images. I have the two images present in recently present. So what I will do, I will run the Nginx image. So docker run -itd-p. See, this we have seen earlier. To run any of the container, this is the image, this is the command to run any of the container, okay. But additionally, what we have to add, we have to add -v means you are adding the volume as well. So now you have to mention that you are linking the volume from which path to which path. As we have seen here, we have to make a soft link, or we have to say we have to link these two folders. So what I will do, root and volume, what the directories I have created right now. So I am linking this volume to any of our folder inside the Nginx. Suppose, as I remember, one folder is there, user share NGINX, and inside the HTML folder comes, okay. So what I am doing, I am just making a volume of group of this one. So I have to give my image name. So what happened, see, docker ps, immediately one of my container came up. We previously also did the same process to run the container, but here only we made one changes. What? That volume, we have linked this path, volume dot test path, to this path inside our docker container, okay. So what I will do now, let me go inside this volume test. So see, right now nothing is present inside this folder, nothing is there. So now what I will do, I will just run this, I will move inside this container. So what is the command? Docker exit -it along with the container ID and any of the command. So I run this. So see, I am inside the container. You can prove by giving the host name as well. See, the host name I got, the which is same as here, and the container ID. So I am inside the container. Now which path I have linked? I have linked this path. So let me move inside this path. So see, I am inside this path right now. Okay. Now let me open the duplicate session of this one so that I can make you understand one concept. So it is opened. Let me clear the screen. Let me maximize this size. Yeah. So see what I will do now. I will move inside the volume test. Why? Because what I linked? I linked this root volume test to this user share nginx HTML. So what I will do now? I will just run the command make directory DevOps G. So what I did, I made a directory inside this container. See, inside the container I had made a directory, nothing where I made a directory. But if I will give a ls command over there, see, it is reflecting. What I mean to say that, whatever modification I did there, I am able to view here. So now see, I will remove it from here. I will delete this directory from here. I am not removing this directory from container. So see what will happen. When I am removing this directory, now I give ls command. See, it is no file is there, no directory is there. So what I mean to say that both the directory become mirror of each other. Whatever will be present inside this root volume test will be reflecting the same inside this nginx HTML. So now come back to our scenario. That in our scenario we have seen that we are making a mirror of container to our local host machine. What is the advantage of this? Suppose if our container goes down, then also we will be having the data in our local host server. So this is the advantage. So we have seen what is the docker volume. I think you got aware of this, what the docker volume is. So we have seen both the commands. Like we tried with the docker volume. Always remember that whenever we will use the command docker volume create, it will always create your volume inside this folder, and very rarely we use this command. Maximum of the time we will use the command docker run -itd-pv, whichever I have shown you now, just now. So maximum of the times we use the same command only. We just used to link our container any of the directories or file to the host machine directories or file. So this is what I have shown here in, with the practical as well. So I think everything I have covered over here. So let me check once. Okay. Let me check. Show you one more thing. Suppose I came inside this container. Okay. So what is my port number? My port number is 32776. Okay. So see what message I am getting. So see actually what happens. Actually what is happening that inside this folder we are not able to find any of the directory. And whenever Nginx will run, Nginx will show the output only whatever present inside this. Okay. So what I will do, I will just make an index.html and inside the I will put any of the thing. HTML H1. This is Nginx server testing. So what I am doing, I am just putting any message to just display. Okay. So see what will happen now. You can view the message. So this is the message what I kept. So now if I will press the refresh again, so this is Nginx server testing. That is what means simply I want to say. And see if I will go to this Docker volume, again here also I am able to view the same thing. Here also I am able to view the same thing. So what I mean to say that whatever we will modify inside this root volume directory, we will be able to fetch the same thing from this directory. So this is what the Docker volume is. So that is the main funda or main concept of the Docker volume, and that is the main advantage of the Docker volume as well. So I think I have covered all the topics mentioned over here. So I will request you to please practice all the sessions whatever I am discussing. And if you want to get all these documents whatever I have prepared, you can go to my Facebook page. One group is there, DevOps. So you can go to the DevOps group and you can download it from there. I will upload all my documents over there. You can simply download it from there and please do the practice along with the watching the video, because only watching the video is not going to help you. Okay. So this is sufficient for this video. We will come with another concept in the another video. Okay. Bye bye.